Hey, it's Greta here. In this short video, I'm gonna answer the question, how long does it take to reverse insulin resistance? And I'll explain it in a way that will make a lot of sense. So first, you need to understand that insulin resistance doesn't happen overnight. It's a long process of eating wrong foods that our bodies were not designed to eat. This eating of wrong foods causes various health complications. See insulin resistance as miscommunication between you and your body. Your body wants A, B, and C to be healthy and function properly, for all biochemical reactions to happen, for production of energy, making hormones, rebuilding the tissues of your body, cell repair, all this. And instead of giving your body A, B, and C, you give your body X, Y, Z. And if that's all what your body gets, even if that's not exactly what it needs, your body will do its best to survive with what it gets. But over time, this issue will get bigger and bigger. So to understand the A, B, and C example, which is your actual nutritional requirements, let's look at what we eat today and how our diets changed recently. When we look at the macronutrient composition of a regular person's diet, not following any diet in particular, you'll see that most of their calories come from dietary carbohydrates. It is recommended to get around 50% of our daily calories from carbs, and our food system is shaped following this recommendation. You go food shopping, shops are stacked with tons of carbs. All foods you'll find will contain high amounts of carbs. You go to a restaurant, most of the meals on the menu will also follow this recommendation and contain around 50% of calories from carbs. Now, the question is, does our food system match with our actual nutritional requirements? There are three macronutrients, carbs, protein, and fat. All of them can provide energy, but two of them have many more functions in the body and are way more useful. Carbs only provide energy. You eat carbs, they turn into glucose, and you use it as energy. Carbs don't have any other major use in the body. Then if we look at protein, it's used for repairing and regenerating body tissues and cells, a healthy functioning immune system, and production of hormones. As we see, protein is way more useful in the body than carbs. Then let's look at fat. Fat is needed for brain development, making hormones, and helping in absorption of fat-soluble vitamins. All cell walls in our bodies are made up of fat. It's called the phospholipid bilayer. It regulates what goes into the cell. And our brains are mostly made up of fat and cholesterol. It is the fattiest organ in the body, consisting of up to 60% fat. Our brains have the highest level of cholesterol in the body. It contains approximately 20% of whole body cholesterol. So, as we see, dietary fat is also far more important than carbs. What do you think? Is avoiding fat and cholesterol good for the brain? As we see so far, the least useful macronutrient is consumed in largest amounts by most of us. And what about energy? Carbs are the best source of energy. It's our main fuel source. Humans wouldn't be able to survive even a day without glucose. This means we must eat carbs. That's a common misconception. There are no essential carbohydrates, as body can make its own glucose. You can make enough of glucose from the protein and fat that you eat. This process is called gluconeogenesis. You can basically make 100% of the glucose that your body needs without eating even a gram of carbs. And you can switch from glucose being your primary source of fuel into ketones that are a far cleaner energy source than glucose. Running on ketones gives you more energy and less metabolic waste. So what does that have to do with insulin resistance? Our bodies crave for ketones. We should be using ketones and not glucose as our primary source of fuel. Carbs are broken down into sugar after you eat them. This sugar is then controlled by the hormone insulin. Insulin brings glucose to the cells. Insulin resistance happens when years after years, you've been eating wrong types of food. Evidence for this is that the low-carb, high-fat ketogenic diet has been shown to reverse insulin resistance, fatty liver, cognitive impairment, Alzheimer's disease, type 2 diabetes, obesity, cancer, and so many other health conditions. It seems that our bodies finally start to function the way they should when you switch to a low-carb, high-fat ketogenic diet. I will leave a list of references in the description of this video. So why is the low-carb, high-fat, moderate-protein, ketogenic diet so useful for preventing diseases and even helping to reverse them? I believe that the ketogenic diet is what we're designed to eat. That's a healthy, balanced diet, low in sugar and low in carbs. This diet is made up of natural whole foods, and it provides us with all the nutrients that we need. We're not designed to eat tons of grain products, such as pasta, bread, and rice. I'll remind you that this high-carb diet is a quite recent thing. Only since 1978 and 1983, people are advised by the government to reduce their fat intake, avoid saturated fat, and switch to eating carbs and vegetable oils. We see that type 2 diabetes and obesity and other diseases have been skyrocketing after people switched to eating carbs instead of fat and using inflammatory vegetable oils instead of using natural fats such as butter, ghee, and coconut oil. And I hope this whole explanation makes sense. Now, how long does it take to reverse insulin resistance? The consequence of eating the wrong types of food for years. So let's say you're 40 right now. You have pre-diabetes or type 2 diabetes. For most of your life, you lived in a world where fat is the enemy and carbs are your friends. You've been handling carbs much better when you were 20. You are more insulin sensitive. You could eat carbs and feel okay, not gain any weight or have blood sugar issues. But the more time passed and you ate the wrong types of food, you ended up building this insulin resistance for around 20 years. Your cells are not happy and they're sick of glucose and insulin because they had too much of it and they start rejecting it. It might take years to reverse insulin resistance. Why so long? You can't remove the damage done over 20 years overnight. It will require hard work and consistency. It will require several years to fix insulin resistance, depending on how much damage there is. You'll have to follow a low-carb, high-fat ketogenic diet with enough of vegetables, healthy fats, and you'll also have to do intermittent fasting regularly. These are the two most effective methods that can bring your insulin down. You can check my other detailed video where I explain how to reverse insulin resistance. It's gonna appear somewhere on the screen right now. And if you have any questions, feel free to ask in the comment section below. If you found this video useful, don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel. You can also support my YouTube channel by buying me a coffee or signing up for my Patreon. Thanks so much for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video.